I would like to start with a brief professional introduction of mine. So I work with ICFAI Business School. I manage the e-learning department over there. I administer Moodle for 6 IBS campuses. But adoption rate is not that good. I also provide e-learning support to ICFAI group of institutions. I train our faculty members and faculty members across India on Moodle, open educational resources, educational technology tools, mobile apps, etc. And here I would like to share my Moodling experience. I started Moodling in the year 2005 as a student. I did a course from Asian Development Bank Institute on e-learning policies. From 2009, I have been exploring as a teacher the Moodle functionality. Since 2010, I have been exploring Moodle as an administrator, Moodle administrator. Moodle has made my life so hectic and busy. This month, I'm not spending a single weekend with my family. So started with IIT Bombay. On December 1st, I was at Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya National Mission on Teachers and Teaching Induction Training Program. And I think, Martin, tomorrow you are going to address the same group. I trained 120 assistant professors. So I request you, please, they'll get some inspiration out of your talk. They're going to serve the nation at least for the next 25 years or so. These all are young assistant professors. So I made them, that training was rigorous. I made them do this, that. So I strictly follow the schedule wherever I go. So the next week, second week was I was at University of Hyderabad. Again, it was as part of the Commonwealth of Learning project. Yesterday, I think Dr. Smita, during her presentation, said they don't have a Moodle site. But I think we, now I want to update on that. Mr. Anil, he's the research scholar, please get her. Research scholar from University of Hyderabad, he only installed that 20 days ago, no? So we use that for capacity building program. 35 faculty members participated in that. And they are going to use this, experiment this from the next semester onwards. Last weekend I was at NIT Warangal, again Pandit Madan Mohan Malvi Induction Training Program. I trained 35. These 2 days I am here. This weekend again at University of Hyderabad for a refresher course, Academic Staff College refresher course. And this month end I am spending with 20 plus faculty members in Vijayawada. The reason I'm telling all this is I'm not boasting myself. India badly needs resource persons in this area. So I request at least 50% of you, please aim for the next level, learn something advanced on Moodle, and contribute to digital India and digital learning. That is my sincere request, so that I will not be overloaded anymore. Okay? And coming to my presentation, creating interactive videos in Moodle courses. So I'm not only focusing on the H5P plugin. Yesterday we had a session, and where is Dr. Vikasa? He presented something on Moodle in medical education. And he also talked about H5P plugin. And Michelle also, she also talked about H5P plugin. So how to create interactive videos using H5P plugin, and I would like to also combine this with the local context. That is creating interactive content in compliance with Ministry of HRD's YM guidelines. So localizing or contextualizing, that is very important. So I thought of administering this poll, and the team said you don't have access to internet. So I'm skipping this. And by the way, how many of you are aware of Swayam or heard of Swayam? So what is the full form? Actually, this poll is that on that only. What is the full form of Swayam? Any answers or any guesses? Okay. So this is Swayam. Study webs of active learning for young aspiring minds. So young minds are aspiring for active learning. not for passive learning. Please remember that. Moodle enables us designing active and dynamic learning environments. So Moodle stands for modular, you all of us know, modular, object oriented, dynamic. So there we have dynamic, inspire, we have active. So please have this in mind. Don't just use Moodle as a CMS, content management system. Use it as an LMS, learning management system. The more you engage your students in interactive, collaborative, and reflective learning, the more they'll retain. As I said, SWIM stands for Study Webs of Active Learning for Young Aspiring Minds. And this is the Indian MOOC platform for offering courses from high school to university level. And how many of you have gone through the SWIM guidelines, Ministry of HRD SWIM guidelines? How many of you are from higher education institutions, by the way? So never gone through those guidelines. Huh? Okay, the point 6.3 talks about production activities, presentation techniques, and point 6.4 talks about post-production activities. They insist on use innovative production techniques. For example, animation, interactive exercises, multimedia techniques, etc. And ensure the presence of video interactive elements. That is the reason I have chosen this topic. So majority are using Moodle, and majority may not be knowing about the plugin H5P and how to create interactive content in compliance with SWIM guidelines. And those who would like to offer online courses as per the SWIM guidelines, we should follow the four quadrant approach. Have you heard of this at least? Okay, at least 10% heard of this. Quadrant one talks about video lectures. So wherever I go for capacity building workshops, I make all the higher education teachers record their at least course introductory video. It's some sort of practice so that they can create their own videos out of their PPTs, adding their voiceover and narration. Coming to the second quadrant, e-content. So generally in India, we talk about self-instructional material or self-learning material. So quadrant two talks about that. Provide students with downloadable e-content in PDF format, case studies, and share web resources, including open educational resources. That is quadrant two. Coming to quadrant three, self-assessment. It includes instructor assessment, self-assessment, as well as peer assessment. Please have, when I'm explaining this, please have Moodle functionality in mind. So whether Moodle supports this four quadrant approach or not. And quadrant four talks about discussion forums. So as I said, try to engage students in reflective learning and provide additional support and address their queries through forums. So when we talk about e-content, why do we need that? To provide flexible access, to accommodate multiple learning styles. Some students may prefer to read text, some may prefer to listen to your audio, some may prefer to watch videos, etc. When you combine all these multimedia elements, automatically it will enrich their learning experience. And we can reuse, share, and adapt, and to promote learning interactions. So in e-learning, generally, we classify learning, teaching-learning interaction into three types. That is, between teacher and student, between learners, and learner and content. So our focus would be on learner and content. Moodle supports all these three types of teaching-learning interactions. But we need to explore Moodle functionality at the optimal level. That's, we are not doing that. We are using it for populating the content. So again, why interactive content? It's a necessary and fundamental mechanism for knowledge acquisition. That's what Barker says. Using interactive content, you can engage students in active and participatory learning. We can promote retention and deeper understanding of the subject matter among the students. This is really important. And we can enable students to self-check their progress and receive real-time results and feedback. Yesterday, I think Dr. Vikasa was talking about if I create a video, using Moodle in medical education. If I create a video and then someone raised, how can we engage students using that video? So here, Moodle plugin provides an answer to that. Student will receive instant feedback as well as results, and it will be added to their gradebook. So different types of interactive activities. If we classify them into technologically simple interactions, technologically complex. We can start with quiz, polls, drag and drop. All these are available in Moodle. And we use choice. Generally, I use this during my workshops, choice, to get the choice from the audience when you would like to start the second day session. So, and I also encourage them to use their mobile app for submitting their poll. And coming to technologically complex interactions, we have interactive videos, animations, scenario-based simulations. So my focus would be on the first one, interactive videos. For creating interactive videos, generally we use various authoring tools. Adobe Captivate, or Presenter, or Camtasia, Articulate Storyline, Lectura, iSpring, etc. But we also have free and open source. I have listed all these on the right side, H5P, EXE Learning, and Xrt. So we are going to explore how we can use H5P for developing interactive videos. We have a plugin, Moodle H5P plugin. You can download that. It's an open source plugin. It's an open source HTML5 authoring tool, and it supports responsive design and supports numerous content types, ranging from interactive content, course participation, dialogue code, drag and drop, fill in the blanks, flashcards. I have created interactive content using the first and the second type, but I'm going to present the first type only, interactive video. So this is again all the content types of H5P. So if you want to, how many of you are here, Moodle administrator, any Moodle administrators here? Majority are there. So you serve for academic institutions only. So then if you didn't install H5P plugin, please install this. You know how to install these are just steps I have listed out. We can install this in two ways. And enable whatever settings you feel useful and disable whichever you feel not required for your teachers. Coming to teachers part. So again, first your default steps. As a teacher, our course page should be on editing mode if you want to add an activity or resource. Then on the activity chooser screen, click on H5P and add. Give a description, as always we do that. Give a name and description and grade, number of marks. And under the editor H5P hub, you select the content type, that is interactive video. Again is that you have details button, please click on that. Then view that, and demo is also available. One link is available for demo, watching the demo. And then click on use button. So interactive video content type. This enables us to enrich our video clip with various interactive elements. Say for example, you want to explain something extra. So you can use the text box, add meaning of that. Or if you want to link it up to any Moodle activity, forum, you can use the text box. Or if you want to link it up to your self-learning material or self-instructional material, which a student can download. Or you can insert extra pictures, and you can link web resources, and you can create quizzes and add bookmarks if any important learning points are there. And you can using this, we can enable students rewind, replay, forward the parts of the video, and they can also set the playback rate. So students will have controls at what speed they would like to play that video. So this is the interactive video editor. We have three tabs for uploading. First one is uploading or embedding a video. Second one is for adding interactive elements. Third one for adding summary tasks. And if you are ready with your video, before adding these interactive elements, we should do some homework or preparatory work. What is that? Any clue? Those who have already used this. So, just preview your video. So identify the markers wherever, minute and seconds, both, wherever you would like to embed these elements. That is the preparatory work or homework. Okay? And by clicking on the plus button, it will allow us to either embed or upload video. How many of you generally upload a video? But I never recommend, please don't do that. Log into YouTube, publish and embed that, so that we can avoid load on the server. I always suggest this. So with using Gmail, you can log in, publish and get the shareable link and get that YouTube URL and click the insert button, and then you need to add copyright information. Yeah, sorry. These are all various interactive elements available. You can click on every element and explore what it does. And you can add interactions. So you can just drag and drop an element onto your video wherever, whenever you would like to display it. And this is text box. As I said, we have linked some discussion forums. This is discussion forums, attached a case study and discussion forums, then glossary also we have attached. So similar way you can add a link here. I think I added learnmoodle.net link and adding an MCQ. Here I would like to stress on one point. It allows us to randomize the options, and you can also use adaptive settings so that based on students' correct or incorrect answer, we can set the display time for that. So these all are screenshots of that student attempting MCQ attempt. And coming to the last tab, that is adding summary tasks. This is nothing but adding a set of statements so that student can reflect on their learning, what they have learned from your video and from your narration. So again, this is an attempt of a student. And bookmarks is also important. You identify different learning points and you can insert bookmarks. Actually, we are not playing that video. It's not the same PPT. No, link is not there. No. Anyway, session. So I thought of showing a video. I screen recorded.
In allocating capital in corporates engaged in
it's been hyperlinked
products
to this.
Or rendering services.
Yeah, just for 2 minutes.
In all organizations.
Just for 2 minutes.
Yeah, we're really getting quite late now, so go on quickly.
Commercial or non-commercial enterprises. One of the main objectives is sustaining the growth of the business activity. This is measured through growth in revenues, in profits, assets, net worth, and market capitalization. Growth can be achieved in the organization through capital expenditure for expansion, moderate in allocating capital
forward
corporates engaged in manufacturing project.
Further.
On these assumptions, in the company's various businesses, the CEO Kosuo Hirai announced a major restructuring strategy aimed at staunching massive liquidity.
Yeah, this is how that interactive element pops out. So all those blue dots are indicating text interactions, and purple is for assessments. So this, you should answer this. Does Moodle support four quadrant approach of SPIAM or not? So we have a video, and we have e-content hyperlink, that is SLM, and we have third quadrant is assessment, and again here a forum, it's been hyperlinked. Thank you.